drew a line in the sand. Watch the tide roll in, wash away my resolution. Made me realize that I just can't stop loving you.
Last
There's
one.
No one.
Would you give your last roller to?
Touches me. Oh, hang on.
Oh, you're lucky.
What's that?
A cherry No, it's just a cherry bassett. It's not a throat one. Touch me, keep your sugar levels up.
Yeah. Of course, you can eat these while you're on the bus, because you get free bus rides.
Only because you haven't applied for
Who would have thought?
You haven't applied for yours, eh? Look, Mick Jagger bus pass.
Who would have thought, 30 years ago, that all these rock and roll icons would be travelling on the buses for free? Okay, we digress.
You filmed it.
Yeah. I just needed something wet in my mouth.
Are you? Because you're doing a lot of talking, aren't you?
No, because I just wanted something wet in my mouth. Okay.
So where are we? We're in America. We're in the studio, Bob Dylan's studio.
That's right.
You're calling the album Desire.
Yeah. So we were, somebody sent me an email recently and told me all about it, because I don't remember much, to be honest. I just remember doing a tune where there's a bar of five, musically speaking, with Bob. And I couldn't figure it out. I don't think anybody could quite figure it out. They were just playing and scared to ask, But I said, look, could you just play it? And we worked it out by the piano, and that was nice. That was kind of, to me, broke the ice to work it out. Instead of just going in and playing and hoping for the best, we worked it out. Because as I said before, I'm not really keen on what you call jamming. Yeah, jamming. Jamming for jamming. So it depends what you're jamming, but anyway. Excuse me. So anyway, yeah, we did that, and at the end of the session, we knew it was the end because the producer came down and said, okay, guys, that's it for tonight. Bobby's losing his voice. And, Jim Mullen, being a jazzer, wasn't quite enamored anyway by Bob. But it was a good time. It was a good time. I won't tell you that. What he said, but it was a really nice the studio was just full of musical icons. Eric Clapton, a violin player, can't remember her name, she's so famous I can't remember her name, all of us Kokomo, and I think I'm on that album, actually. I've listened to a track where Bob gets the credit for playing the piano, but it sounds just like me, funnily enough. Or maybe he just plays like me. Uh-huh. Or maybe I play like him, whatever. So, anyway, it's, who knows? You can't prove anything, and it's not really, my big thing to go chasing for the credits. Next. Cool. He's a bit slow, isn't he? This
country, Miss Wheat.
This interview.
Anyway, so after Kokomo,
yes,
10cc, was it? You joined 10cc.
I did. Yeah. Was it after Kokomo?
Kokomo folded.
Well, Kokomo never really folded. Oh. To be honest, we continued. Didn't really fold, but things weren't happening gig wise and money wise. People that members had to go off and work with other bands, like the singers went work with Alvin Lee, you know, from 10 years after.
I think all the top stars of the day use Kokomo musicians.
Yeah.
Brian Ferry.
Yeah. They were all working with different...
Mel Collins played with the Stones, didn't he?
Yeah, Mel did.
Dire Straits and...
Maybe. Yeah, Mel was a bit of a slag at least. Mel played with anybody and everybody. Yeah, the Stones, Dire Straits and... Mel was...
Frank Paddy and Don, Ian Drury, Brian Ferry, Marianne Faithfull.
Yeah, you know, yeah.
Incredible, really.
The list is endless. And,
your story a bit later on. When you played the Bahamas, you got an ant call, not good.
Oh.
A money spider.
Oh.
You're going to come in some money. The Bahamas, and Bowie came down and...
Oh, it wasn't...
Nicked all the musicians.
Bermuda, sorry. That's true, yeah. It came and nicked all the musicians.
We'll get back to that. You had all the top, shit-top musicians.
In Kokomo, yeah.
In Kokomo, just as you do today. Everyone wants to play with you. Everyone wants to play with Tony O'Malley.
Mm. But is that really... Everyone wants to play with me. Well, I don't know.
Monopoly.
Yeah.
No, we'll come
is that
back
a plug for your song?
Oh, that's a very good memory. I've forgotten I've written that one. Yes, I actually have this song called Monopoly.
Yeah. Keith, this interview is not about you.
Oh, okay.
But anyway,
I digress.
Enjoy yourself. So, where was I? Where was we?
I got a bit confused because I went on.
Where were we?
On Kokomo.
Tennessee. Yes. Well, I'd mentioned before.